I think you all have had the problem that you want to shoot a video, but it won't work out. So let's make a short movie about it for the Aperture Light Dislocation contest. My name is Victor Bart, I'm from Dutch Video Shooter on YouTube, and this is my behind the scenes. This is my location, and it's actually my own YouTube studio. What have I done with the lights? You see some RGB lights here? And these are just RGB strips from the dollar store. Really cheap stuff. Also here behind the heater is an RGB strip, also from the dollar store. Here on top we have an IKEA light strip, and also here we have IKEA light strips. So I have a practical approach in my lights. But here we have a light tube, and this is from Letco, an AltaTube 120C. They are not yet on the market, but I won one. The cool thing about this tube is RGB and other effects and filters. So this is a really practical light also to have just in my studio. I have four Aperture M9s. They are really nice little lights with a built-in battery. And I'm not really have a plan yet for them. But you can easily stick them in a place to have a little bit of accent light, or use the leaf filter pack and make little filters to make it in RGB colors or any other color you want. So here we have my Aperture 20D, and I really love this light. You can really shape the light with the barn doors, and the lens can be adjusted inside and dimmable, and filters of course. But it is really a hard light, but I will use this to make shots a little bit better, just move it around to fill up some spots. But to make it a soft light, you can put like a shower curtain over it. And this is a piece of a few dollars in the dollar store. And now you have a nice soft light. Meet Lee, my robot. And the robot is made out of an iFootage monopod. And the head is a meerfuck light. And that's a really nice little light that you can control from your smartphone, by color, with little color filters and a built-in battery. I think the robot is a little bit sad because the robot knows what I'm gonna do with it. I'm gonna shoot this film solo, and I'm not an actor, so that will be interesting. But this is my camera package on a big Miller tripod. I'm probably gonna end up with just tripod shots and see how much I can pull out of a tripod shot. So no fancy movement, but more like nice framing and stuff like that, or I at least try to. So my main camera is Panasonic GH5 with a speed booster with Canon FD prime lenses. So for the audio we have a Rode NC1 and a Rode Filmmaker kit. Here on top we have the Axun module to have HDMI over Wi-Fi to a tablet. So I will use my tablet as a viewfinder to see what I'm doing. So it's always a nice challenge to shoot a project like this on one prime lens, but not me. This is my lens kit that I gonna use. I have a Canon FD lens kit from 17mm up to 200mm with even two macro lenses. I probably will end up using the 24 and the 35 the most. The behind the scenes camera that I'm using is my old Panasonic GH3, and that will be also a prop in my short film. So let's set up the first shot. But I probably won't gonna film that much about the shooting itself, because I really need to concentrate on making the best film possible that I can, to see how far I can push myself to create something really awesome. The first shot will be a shot where I film the barrel of the gun in focus, and the rest will be out of focus. And here we have my robot flashing. And here we have my camera setup with the tablet as monitor. Here we have the Aperture Mini 20D to catch some extra light on the gun. I put an M9 here to fill up this shadow. To do a top-down shot, I built this overhead rig with a light stand and some rigging stuff. So my camera is now hanging here with a 28mm lens. So when I open the drawer, you have a nice view of it. And there are M9s inside of it, just to make it a little bit more interesting. And here I have the Mini 20D to have a nice light on top of it. And here on the tablet you can see how the shot looks like. This GNL light panel is really reflective, but we can use that for the shot. I'm now filming this light panel, and in the reflection of the light panel, you can see this computer playing a video. I put a Mini 20 behind me as a backlight, and here's a little M9 because the camera will be here, and otherwise it was too dark. So let's shoot this reflection shot, and my friend Frederico made a little clip as the happy filmmaker. It was really dark in this corner, so what I have done is I put an M9 in between there with two blue light filters. So we're now gonna turn this staircase into a movie scene. Here we have the Mini 20D with some blue filters, and downstairs the Letco Alta tube. And here we have a lot of fake leaves. So I'm gonna use this as prop to make this scene more interesting. I put a lot of leaves in front of the lights to create these patterns on the wall and on my face. And also here with the blue light I put a lot in front of it. And I put a fan here so everything will move around. This is the last scene and I went for a soft light setup. So I put some shower curtain around the light tube. And some shower curtain in front of this light panel. It's a wrap! And it was quite a challenge to shoot this short film completely solo with the help of Frederico.
And my website, links down below. Don't forget, guys!
Thanks, Frederico, I really love it. I want to give you one last tip about audio. Because the eerie sounds you hear, I made them completely myself here in the studio with my audio recorder and a hand mic. So what I did is, I scratched the microphone on the metal plate here and without the cover here on the heater. And that makes the eerie sounds, and also on the back here on the metal, the pounding sound. Really simple and easy. Just put on headphones, take your microphone and put it on surfaces and see what you get. The word that you need to use in a short film is the word accent, but I don't gonna tell you where I put it in. It's clearly in it, because if I will say it or explain it, it gives away too much of the story, because the story is made around the word. I still need to make the floor plan for the competition, but here's my storyboard for the first part of the film. The rest I did in storyboard and had the idea in my head, but here I wrote out how I wanted to shoot. But this shot didn't turn out how I wanted it, but then I found out the reflection and replaced it by a way different shot, which is epic. While shooting this short film, I learned a lot about lighting, so please practice your lighting, and next year I will be back in this competition, and thanks for watching.